younger head.
I am curious about your presentation, which was, you know, I am impressed. The only one I've heard speak that quickly was a Texas auctioneer, but I tried really hard to concentrate and get it all. The earth was created 6,000 years ago in 6 days by God. I am confused. Being philosophically consistent and being a very honest person, I'm sure you can tell me where God came from. And in addition, once you've told me where God comes from, please try to clarify how you can figure that a spiritual force can have an impact on a material universe to create it. I think that some years ago we already talked about that kind of thing in philosophical circles, at any rate, by posing the question, if angels are made of spiritual matter, and a pin is made of material matter, and spiritual matter displaces no space, how many angels can dance on the tip of a pin? I have a sense of sort of reversal experience here, but please do, go ahead.
You got 5 minutes. Now, I just want to know which question.
That's all right. You may take the rest of the minutes.
We're supposed to do one question at a time. Which one would you like? That was part of the format for the debate. So which question?
I want you to fill in the story of the rest of the beginning of the universe. God, spiritual matter, impact on material matter.
Okay. So two questions. All right.
Go ahead.
All right. Your question, where did God come from, assumes that you're thinking of the wrong, obviously it displays that you're thinking of the wrong God, because the God of the Bible is not affected by time, space, or matter. If he's affected by time, space, or matter, he's not God. Time, space, and matter is what we call a continuum. All of them have to come into existence at the same instant, because if there were matter but no space, where would you put it? If there were matter and space but no time, when would you put it? You cannot have time, space, or matter independently. They have to come into existence simultaneously. The Bible answers that in 10 words. In the beginning, there's time. God created the heaven, there's space, and the earth, there's matter. So you have time, space, matter created, a trinity of trinities there. Just, you know, time is past, present, future. Space has length, width, height. Matter has solid, liquid, gas. You have a trinity of trinities created instantaneously, and the God who created them has to be outside of them. If he's limited by time, he's not God. The guy who created this computer is not in the computer. He's not running around in there changing the numbers on the screen, okay? The God who created this universe is outside of the universe. He's above it, beyond it, in it, through it. He's unaffected by it. So for, and the concept that a spiritual force cannot have any effect on a material body, well then I guess you'd have to explain to me things like emotions and love and hatred and envy and jealousy and rationality. I mean, if your brain is just a random collection of chemicals that formed by chance over billions of years, how on earth can you trust your own reasoning processes and the thoughts that you think? Okay, so your question, where did God come from, is assuming a limited God. And that's your problem. The God that I worship is not limited by time, space, or matter. If I could fit the infinite God in my 3-pound brain, he would not be worth worshiping, that's for certain. So that's the God that I worship. Thank you.